Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with our subject web technologies. This is another topic in this subject that we are going to discuss is the www. So this is everyone knows about this www. So then what is this www? I think they don't know. They are simply using www.com dot some URL. Okay, google.com, gmail.com, everything they are using. Then what is this www? It's a world wide web. Okay, so in this video, I want to give a clear description about this World Wide Web. Okay, what are the web pages and what are the web applications that are accessing by using this www, World Wide Web. So it is a huge collection of pages, means this World Wide Web is having a huge collection of page of informations linked to each other around one globe. So one page is connected to another page is connected to another page over the globe. Okay, it's a huge collection of pages of information. And every page is a combination of text, pictures, audio, video, animation and hyperlinks. So whatever the web page that you are going to access, this page consisting of so many combinations. Okay, so text, picture, audio, everything will be there, hyperlinks that is present on this web page, www. Okay, and first the Berners-Lee is the father of this World Wide Web. So he is started this web pages. Now let's see the web pages. So what is in the World Wide Web? We are accessing the web. Okay, web pages. So what is this web page? A web page is a collection of normal text, picture, video clips, audio clip and hyperlinks. Okay, it can be designed with HTML, XML or JavaScript. So how you are going to create the web pages? So in the Notepad or in some any other software that is provided, okay, in that you are going to create, you are designing a page with the HTML, XML or JavaScript, etc. So HTML, what is the use of the HTML? HTML is used to design the structure, means how the page has to be appeared. Appearance. Okay, the HTML is used to design the structure where the image has to be present and where the boxes has text boxes has to be present. Okay, and where the text has to be placed, everything like that. So HTML is used to design the structure. So we will say the pictures files as .html like that. Then what about the JavaScript? I said the web pages the web pages are created by using the JavaScript also. The JavaScript, it validates the field. Whatever the fields that are present, the design structure that we created in the web page, to validate that fields, okay, that text boxes, we use the JavaScript. And XML is just like a HTML. It's just an advanced version of the HTML. So that is a web page. So a web page consisting of the normal text, images, video clips and some hyperlinks, everything will be present. So the web page is designed by using the HTML, JavaScript and XML. Okay, so the first page I created. So like this, the different pages we are creating. So what's the use of creating that pages? So that pages has to be linked one by one. So whenever I click one link, it has to navigate to the another page. Okay, so that's completely becomes the website. Let's see the website. So in the World Wide Web, it's just in a website. We are accessing the website by using that www. A website is a collection of interlinked web pages. So obviously, so whenever if you read completely this page, if you want to navigate to another page, you have to click on the hyperlink. So that hyperlink is going to navigate to another page. Another page. So that is only the website. So whenever if you open the Gmail, whenever you're given the username and password, whenever you click the button or whenever you click on the hyperlink, it is going to enter into the next page. Okay, it's a inbox page you are going to enter. So just like it's a web, that is a website. Whenever you are navigating to the another page, it becomes a website. A website is a collection of interlinked web pages. The website is accessed to the URL. So with the help of the URL, you are going to access. The URL is like http www.gmail.com. Okay, like that. So this completely you call it as a URL. Okay, it's a URL. It's just an address. Okay, if if you want to go to somewhere, you need to if you need to know the address, then only you can go to that place. In the just in the same way, the in the website also, if you know the URL, you can access that website. That is just an address. URL is nothing but the address to where you have to go. To where you have to go. So if you want to access any particular website, you need to know the URL. Okay, Uniform Resource Locator. URL is a global address of web documents on World Wide Web. So it's just a global address of web documents on World Wide Web. The URLs are unique in nature and may not don't have a copy. Obviously, because if I want to access a particular website, that should be unique. It should not be repeated. If just like that, if you say if you want to create a Gmail account, that Gmail account should be a unique. The same account should not be given to the different another different persons, because that is a unique. That is a URL. Okay, so the URL, so just like that, the URL so is also unique in nature and may don't have any copy. Actually, the URL is of two types. One is the protocol and another is indicated with the resource name. The complete URL is divided into two parts, protocol and resource name. So, example, see here. http://www.google.com. So, I already explained HTTP. It's a protocol. It's a basic service provided by the internet to enter into that, navigate to that server. So HTTP is a protocol, hypertext transfer protocol, and www.google.com is a resource name. Okay, this protocol is the same, and the resource name is whatever the website page address that you can give here. So this is about the website. The website is characterized according to their they are categorized into their functions, like personal websites. You are having their own personal websites, commercial websites. It means everyone can access that website and they can post the messages, they can retrieve the message, everything. That is a commercial websites. And the, or like you can take this websites like Amazon, okay, or else you can take the fashion websites, or for groceries purchasing, those are all comes under the commercial websites. And the government websites, like if the Aadhaar card websites, okay, all the related to the government .gov.in, like that, those comes under the government websites. So the complete websites are characterized into their functions according to their functions as personal websites, commercial websites, and government websites. Actually, there are two types of websites, static and dynamic, which you call it as a static and which you call it as a dynamic. So you can take your personal websites as a static websites, because in the static websites you are having the information, lot of information you are storing in your site, in your, that you call it as a personal website, information site. The another name for the static website is the information site. It has a complete information. It has the database consisting of complete information. The dynamic website, those are the interactive sites, just like the government or the commercial, everything is the interactive sites. Okay, they don't have the complete information. Whatever the link you want, you can access that link, and that will be provided by the get the information from that particular database. Okay, so the complete websites are divided into two types. One is a static and another is the dynamic, information site and the interactive sites. Now, coming to the another concept in this World Wide Web is the talk about the web applications. So in the World Wide Web, you learn about the web pages and the websites. Now coming to the web applications. So which items you call it as a web applications? Now let's see. You can run web application into browsers by through URL. Obviously, so just like in websites, you can run those web applications into the browser using URLs. So there are two types of web applications. One is a service oriented and one is a presentation oriented. So what is the service oriented and what is this presentation oriented? Let's see. The services oriented applications are, it is used to implement the web services. It's a service oriented, means which is used to implement the web services. It is coding using CGI, JSP, ASP. With the help of these languages, we can develop the web services. Okay, next is a presentation oriented web application. So it is provides a client side services. presentation, whatever you are able to see on the desktop, that is a presentation oriented web application, which is provided by the client side services. So they are coded using the HTML, XML, JavaScript. Okay, so these should be interlinked with each other. Then only you can access, you can make it as a dynamic website. If you want to make it as a dynamic website, these should be connected to each other. The HTML should be connected to this JSP. Then the page becomes the dynamic website. The website becomes the dynamic. Okay. So the complete web applications may be the service oriented or presentation oriented web applications. Now coming to the another concept in this World Wide Web is the web architecture. The World Wide Web follows the two-tier architecture. So what is that? The WWW follows the two-tier architecture. Two-tier architecture means it's combination of web server and web client. Okay, so that's why we call it as a two-tier. One is a web server and another is a web client. With the combination of these two, we can access the website. The web server produces and delivers the information. What is the role of the web server? It is going to produce and deliver the information, whereas a web client is retrieves and displays the information. Client side, the web client is going to just retrieve and display the information, whatever that is server is provided. The server is produce and delivers the information. So see here, these are all the web clients. You can call it as a web clients. The web clients are all connected to the some local internet, the switch router. A firewall will be connected to the present in one internet is present in here and here. So the firewalls will be there between the router and the internet for the security purpose. And here the web server is there. So here the web client retrieve